Welcome back to a video on my channel, and today I will be discussing WWF. What does the charity with the iconic panda actually do in our crazy complex world? Let's start off with the meaning behind WWF. The abbreviation stands for Worldwide Fund for Nature. The original name was World Wildlife Fund, but it was changed in 1986. I won't go into the history behind the company, because this isn't a history channel. It's a climate change channel. So the question remains, what does Worldwide Fund actually do? The short answer is stopping the degradation of the planet's natural environment and to build a better future in which humans live in harmony with nature. They started doing this by donating money to local organizations to protect local endangered species. Today, that would be equivalent to protecting black rhinos and Eimer leopards. The numbers are extremely low and nearing extinction. You could think that it wouldn't be too difficult to increase their numbers to a healthy community by protecting them. But inbreeding is a high possibility in such low numbers. So having so few individuals is worse than you might think. Since then, they've increased their global influence and work areas. On their website, they've divided their projects into 14 categories. It would be too much to cover them all in one video, so I will be discussing these three: climate, wildlife conservation, and oceans, all of which give you a very important insight into the global issue. So what are examples of their actions regarding climate change? One of them is reducing CO2 emissions from deforestation. Trees are enormous carbon storages and shouldn't be cut down on such a large scale. WWF is working on funds to properly protect these forests and protect them from illegal logging. In developing countries like Brazil, these trees are like money to the inhabitants. It may be unfair to treat a developing country like this, but it is needed to keep this world balanced. Bringing ecosystems out of balance is the absolute devil these days. Another example of WWF's actions is encouraging the Paris Agreement. They do this by helping developing countries to use electricity from wind and solar, instead of using coals and gas. They accomplish this by working together with companies and cities to use their combined financial power to buy solar panels, for example. Another part of this project is ensuring that more of these plants become nationally incorporated, so more solar panels and windmills will be placed. I hope it's clear what WWF does on this climate part. But let's now look at the wildlife conservation part. Tigers, for example, a top predator that keeps the food chain intact. They aim to double the number of tigers by 2022 and support their protection. By doing this, they preserve biodiversity in enormous areas. I've said this many times, and David Attenborough has too. But biodiversity is really the key to this whole problem. Another iconic animal that needs protection is the elephant. Their slaughter rate is absurdly high, and beside from the sad story, unsustainable and destructive to the ecosystem. WWF aims to ban ivory trade completely in Asia. It isn't easy due to ancient beliefs and illegal markets, but hard work will get us there. Hard work is also needed in our oceans. Oceans are being overfished, and WWF is helping local communities to use sustainable fishing methods. But the problem of overfishing is more complex. The bycatch is enormous, and illegal fishing is a problem as well. Together, this is literally emptying our oceans. It is expected that in a couple decades, there will be more plastic in the oceans than ocean life in biomass itself. Plastics are a human invention and are a threat to the oceans. WWF has therefore started a campaign called No Plastic in Nature. They aim to fix the plastic problem by cleaning up the mess and stopping the spreading at its source. 10% of all plastics in our oceans actually come from ghost gear, which is abandoned fishing gear from fishermen. 10% is quite a lot, but ghost gear is the most harmful sort of plastics. As you can see in these pictures, it kills ocean life wherever it goes. This is an inspiring picture I found on WWF's website. And I suppose the other asks us a question. If this comes from humans, what the hell will our future look like? Answer that question for yourself. What do you think the future will look like? because the plastic bottle that this other is holding will break up in small pieces, end up in the food chain, and eventually in your own body. Today I discussed just three of the project types of WWF. But if you guys enjoy it, I will make a second part. For now, thank you for watching and spreading the message. If you don't spread the message, we will. Really. We need more activists to push this movement. So subscribe and share this video. To end the video, I would like to share a famous quote, which could actually be interpreted in a climate change context. Only when the last tree has been cut down, the last fish has been caught, and the last stream poisoned, we will realize that we cannot eat money.